On Acoustic Tuesday, episode number 46, we're going to have a look at the Guitar Geek Aura, see which artist Acoustic Tuesday viewer George Van Wynn recommends, and we're going to listen to some absolutely mouth-watering guitars. These things are amazing. All that and more right after this.
If you believe that playing acoustic guitar is about sharing the joy of music with friends and family, not just mastering the technical side of playing, then this show is your dream come true. Every Tuesday morning, I give you my list of exciting guitar geek discoveries, gear, and new music so you can stay inspired to live your best acoustic life. I'm Tony Polecastro, and this is the Acoustic Tuesday Show. Guitar geeks, unite.
Welcome officially to Acoustic Tuesday, episode number 46. This is the show where you're going to discover new acoustic guitar gear, learn about acoustic artists, and get inspired to live your best and boldest acoustic life. As with all Acoustic Tuesday episodes, I'm going to share with you my guitar geek list for the week. But before we dive into that, I've got a little Acoustic Tuesday tradition that I'd like to share with you. Here is your guitar geek trivia question for the day. After Mississippi John Hurt was rediscovered and started playing again, he didn't own a guitar. In 1964, the Newport Foundation gave John Hurt funding to purchase a guitar he could call his own. He ended up buying a Guild F30. Who now owns Mississippi John Hurt's Guild F30? Is it A, John Oates, B, Boy George, C, Michael Stipe, or D, Slash? Go ahead and ponder that, and at the end of the episode, I'll be sure to give you the answer. Here we are. Let's get comfy in episode number 46 of Acoustic Tuesday. And of course, making sure that we're all at ease and feeling good is none other than Sir Noah Jacob Heckman Jr. the first. Noah, cheers to you, buddy.
Tony, cheers to you as well.
What do you happen to be cheersing this fine Tuesday?
So today, I am cheersing the Lagavulin 8.
Oh, nice.
Which, to my knowledge, is a recent, almost like re-release.
Okay.
Of the eight year.
Okay.
That was originally back like in the late 1800s.
Oh.
And so I am enjoying it. It's good. I'm glad.
Fantastic.
It was a good purchase.
Well, good. I'm glad.
And what about you? What are you?
Well, I have the Bullet. This is new to me. I didn't know that this existed. This is the Bullet Bourbon Barrel Strength, which I'm a huge fan of barrel strength bourbons. And when I saw this at the store, I absolutely flipped out because I didn't know they did this. Basically, I'm assuming in my mind, I just picture them going up to a whiskey barrel with a drill, drilling a hole into it, and then putting this bottle underneath. And that's the way that I like my bourbon, and it tastes absolutely delicious. It's actually, it's a little bit cinnamony. It's not fireball cinnamony. It's like the good spice, like the true earthy cinnamony.
Okay. Yeah, because the image I had was you, like, you know how like puddles collect in like mud during rainy season?
Sure, sure.
And you just like grab your straw and I see.
That's cute. I'm glad you think that way about bourbon. That really doesn't hurt anybody's feelings at all. Don't worry. I'm going to go ahead and dive into the geek list today.
Yes.
Because I can't take any more of your insults,
I'm ready.
Quite frankly.
Let's do it.
So first up today, I've been gigging quite a bit lately. Usually summer's a very busy time. Christy Hayes comes back into town. Christy Hayes, I featured her on a previous episode of Acoustic Tuesday, an awesome artist that I'm very fortunate to be able to play with during the summer months when she comes out here and plays music. So I've been gigging a lot lately, some solo stuff and playing with her as well. And I wanted to feature something that makes my live gigs really easy. And it happens to be a DI. Now, I've featured DIs before. In the past, I've featured the Mesa Boogie Rosette DI, which is fantastic. And I've also got another DI, a radial DI, that I really like. So the question is, well, Tony, why do you have all these DIs? Shouldn't you just have one go-to one? Well, I use them in different situations. The radial is like my backup, super simple one, plug and play. The Mesa one is one that I like in louder situations. It has a boost and it has way more EQ and tonal controls, so I can really dial in my tone if I have the time to do it. This next DI, the one that I'm going to share with you, is the one that is really my kind of quick and easy setup DI. Now, a DI, all it does is it takes your guitar signal and it boosts it so that the mixer or soundboard can handle it better. Just so we're all on the same page as to what a DI is. Think of it as almost like a translator in a way. So the DI that I want to share with you is the Fishman Spectrum Aura DI, or the Fishman Aura Spectrum DI. This DI is one that I've had for quite some time. This by no means is a new product. I think it's been out for, on the better end of 7, maybe even more years. But it really is, it's kind of a Swiss Army knife DI. It has every feature that you love in a DI. It has full-blown EQ and all that, but it has the Fishman Aura engine, I want to call it, where they essentially process the guitar pickup signal and make it sound almost as if the guitar was mic'd. Now, there's a little bit more explaining for me to do here, and it's better off not heard from me. Actually, there's a Fishman specialist that I found this killer video where he does a great job explaining it. So let's actually have a watch. Let's watch that right now.
The Aura Spectrum DI gives you the sound quality of a studio mic whenever and wherever you plug in. Fishman's Aura acoustic imaging technology allows acoustic musicians to easily and accurately reproduce the sound of their instrument as if it were mic'd in a professional studio. Aura uses digital algorithms developed in Fishman's audio labs to create an image of the natural sound that microphones capture in a professional studio. This image, when played through an amp, mixer, or PA, blends with your instrument's pickup to produce an immediate and dramatic improvement in your amplified sound. The Aura Spectrum DI is the complete tone solution for the acoustic musician. It features award-winning Aura acoustic imaging technology that restores the sound of a studio mic to your undersaddle or sound hole pickup. The Aura Spectrum DI has a number of features, including a 3-band EQ, 1-knob compressor, automatic feedback suppression with up to 3 notches, a chromatic tuner, an effects loop, and of course a high-quality balanced XLR DI. The included Aura Gallery image software provides access to an ever-expanding list of instruments recorded using world-class studio mics and techniques. Aura Spectrum DI is not only incredibly versatile, but it also delivers the most realistic acoustic sound available for stage or studio.
That's a nice close-up view of the Fishman Spectrum Aura DI. Now, a couple things about this DI. One of the things that I love is the selection of images. Essentially, all I do is pick the body size guitar, and then I basically turn the center knob until I like what I hear. So in terms of dialing in your guitar tone, it's fairly easy. And then if things are wonky with the sound system, then I'll go to the EQ. I usually keep my compression maybe about a quarter of the way up, maybe a little bit less. And as far as the blend, because you can blend between the actual Aura image and the pickup signal, I use almost entirely the pickup signal, maybe 40% of the Aura image, maybe even just a little bit less, because I like the clarity that it offers. Now, so I heard very early on that this particular DI didn't function well with the K&K pickup, and nearly all of my guitars are fitted with the K&K pickup. And I thought, you know, what the hell, I'm just gonna try it. And I gotta be honest, the results have been fine. I definitely veer more towards the end of direct pickup signal because it's a little bit clearer. As you blend in the Aura image, it can get a little bit wonky and almost kind of sound underwater-ish. So just be careful with the blend. But other than that, this is kind of a set it and forget it DI. It's built like a tank, but there are a couple things that I should make you aware of in terms of things that I actually don't like about the DI. The built-in tuner, although it's a great function to have it right there, I don't find is all that accurate. I know they've since updated and just released a different DI, the Pro Platinum, I believe, that tuner is actually way better. This tuner, I'd give it probably about a C, maybe even a C minus. And I also, as much as the anti-feedback can be a lifesaver, I don't prefer using it because it seems to really kind of choke the tone a little bit. It works for some people, it's definitely not my cup of tea. But overall, I think the DI is fantastic. I use it very, very often, and it allows me to really dial in a really solid tone as I'm switching instruments, you know, from a dreadnought to my small single 017. So it's a very versatile, almost a Swiss Army knife DI. In fact, I even have one for my Dobro. It's the same thing, it's just for the Dobro. So I like I said, I really enjoy these. I think it allows you to dial in a tone pretty quickly and without much blood, sweat, or tears. And you can check those out, of course, if you go to acousticlife.tv. There's going to be full-blown links to where you can do plenty of research on it, as well as buy it if that's something that you wish to do or wish to try out. And remember, anything that you buy from acousticlife.tv, any of those links that you use to purchase items, 100% of those proceeds goes to Guitars for Vets. So it's a really good cause. By being a guitar geek, you're supporting other guitar geeks and spreading that healing power of music, which is pretty outstanding, if I do say so myself. All right, moving on. I want to check the mail. Excuse me, I almost lost my voice.
You all right there, Tony?
Noah, what did you put in this?
You poured it. That was you.
But you handed me the bottle.
That's true.
I think he actually slipped some scotch in there. I think he's like, Anyways, I want to visit the mailbag because I got some really interesting stuff. First and foremost, so my dad sent a package to TAC headquarters, Acoustic Life Studios. And a while ago, I had asked for you guys to please, if you're out shopping at a guitar store, if you love your local guitar store, send me a pick from your local guitar store or from a cool place that has, say, guitar picks as a souvenir. And my dad did that. So he chose to send me the juststrings.com pick. So that's going to go in the pick wall, in the cup that will translate to the pick wall. He sent me a Martin pick, which is pretty awesome, and a Rock and Roll Hall of Fame pick, which I thought was a pretty rad addition.
Yeah.
We've gotten picks from all over. There's a lot of great stuff in there. So if you are sitting there and you're thinking, gosh, I'd love to send those guys a pick for the pick wall, please, please do so. The address is pretty simple to remember. It's 2335 Birdie Drive here in Bozeman, Montana, area code 59715. Now, also in the dad care package, you guys got to see this strap that he sent along. It's out of this world. So this is a strap that he uses on his bass. It is a, it's clearly from the 70s because it has mile-long fringe on it.
And it's brown?
And it's brown.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I cannot wait to figure out where I'm going to use this. And part of me thinks he sent this to me as a joke, and part of me thinks that he thinks I'm going to use it. I just don't know where to use it because I feel like the fringes are going to get in the way. And I feel like I need a cape if I use a strap like this. Mm-hmm. But thanks, Dad. I do appreciate it. Next up in the mailbag, I just got the new edition of Guitarist Magazine. Now, very quickly on this magazine. So I originally subscribed to Acoustic Magazine, which was based in the UK. And about two issues in, I was really actually enjoying the magazine. They said that they weren't going to print that magazine anymore, but that they were going to send me Guitarist Magazine. Now, I got one issue of Guitarist Magazine last month, which, of course, means Acoustic Magazine is no more. And while I think it's a good publication, I have found that it doesn't have a lot of acoustic stuff in it, which was a little bit of a bummer. So I wasn't as excited to dig into this. I'm going to dig into it still because ultimately, I am a guitar geek, but just a heads up for those of you thinking of subscribing to this magazine, it's a great read if you just want to know about mostly electric guitars. Very seldom do they do a kind of a purebred acoustic edition, or if they have, I haven't seen one yet. So just a heads up on that, but this came in and I am excited to read it. It makes for good reading. Noah, anything in the mailbag for you?
No.
Bummer.
But you knew that, didn't you?
I did. That's why I asked. And I want to show off this cool pen I have.
Yes.
So Chuck H., who's an Acoustic Tuesday viewer and Tony's Acoustic Challenge member, actually made this pen for me. And he knows that I love skulls and things with skulls on them. Mm-hmm. So this is the skulliest pen I've ever seen. It has a bejeweled skull at the top, bones.
Yeah.
It's a hand. He made a hand-turned pen. So this is now my Acoustic Tuesday pen. And it's got some good heft.
You know, I did get one, too.
You did. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, I got a pen as well. Mine is, I don't have it with me, but it is crushed. It's like green. It has like crushed jade.
Nice.
It's crushed jade, and it is also bejeweled.
All right.
Around the center, and it's a fountain pen.
Oh.
I failed to mention. Is yours a fountain pen?
It's not, because I write more than you.
Oh. Okay.
I need the fluidity of a ballpoint.
But I dig the skulls too.
Thanks. Cool. Thanks. And I like your pen too. I didn't mean to.
Thank you.
I just, Anyways, we should probably move
Let's
on.
Let's move on.
I know. So you've been catching up on past shows, reading comments and things like that. Mm-hmm. People have been leaving shout outs. So
yes.
I think we should just take a second and give some shout outs, share some comments, and see what the folks are saying.
Let's do it. I'm ready. Okay, so some comments and shout outs from last Acoustic Tuesday episode. First one comes from Jeff from Texas. He says, this is my first time at the show and spent half the time pausing the show and looking up all the recommendations.
Oh, nice.
Awesomeness.
Nice. Well, let me say this, Jeff, if you're ever looking for anything I talk about, if anybody's ever looking for anything that I talk about on the show, just go to acousticlife.tv. It is all there with bonus videos, bonus full-blown articles written on it, and of course links if you want to check it out and actually purchase any of the stuff. And all those proceeds do go to Guitars for Vets.
All right, next one comes from, if I read this right, it's Miguel. Greetings from Portugal. All watching right. You every Tuesday and loving it.
Awesome. Thanks, man.
And just so happens, Tony, the third one comes from Chuck H.
Really?
The one who we got our pens from that we just talked about.
That's awesome.
Not planned.
Okay.
Not planned. In other words, we didn't talk about this beforehand.
No.
Chuck says, hey from Chuck from Washington, D.C. Another great episode. Thanks.
Awesome.
Next one comes from Ronnie D. He says, so, as a United States Air Force veteran, 21 years of service, it's so cool to know proceeds from purchases made on acousticlife.tv go to Guitars for Vets. Oh. Simply awesome.
Oh, well, thank you for your service, and thanks for the comment. That's outstanding.
Next one comes from Scott P. Scott from Atlanta. He makes a comment here, and he says, that Elijah bottle, the Elijah Craig bottle in the
one. Oh, from the Guitar Snow? From
the Guitar Snow pick, yeah. He says, that Elijah bottle is not 3/4 empty. It's 1/4 full.
Oh.
Come on, Tony. Optimism.
That's true. That's true. But as a bourbon lover, when you see a bottle that is that full, it saddens you because there's just not a lot left.
Okay, I see. Happens. Well, okay, see enough about bourbon. Yeah. Moving on. last two. One comes from GW. So he just says, morning, everyone, from Tacoma, Washington.
All right.
And Brandon S. says, hi from the shores of Lake Superior.
Fantastic. Well, thanks for tuning in, everybody. And of course, we want to know that you're out there watching. So if you have a comment you'd like to leave, please do so on the YouTube video right there. And of course, let us know where you're tuning in from, because it's always fun to know how many guitar geeks are uniting from all of the far stretches of the globe. It's very cool to hear where you guys are from. So yeah, be sure to leave a comment. Let us know what you think about the show. And gosh, Noah, we've got a ton of stuff to do today.
Let's do it.
We got a ton of stuff to do. Now, real quick, while you're leaving comments, don't forget, if you have not already, please subscribe to this YouTube channel. Just click that red subscribe button, and then don't forget to hit that little bell. That'll give you a notification of each new video that gets released. And of course, if you want Acoustic Tuesday delivered directly to your email, that's an option as well. In fact, most people are doing that. Just click the link in the description, and you can get Acoustic Tuesday delivered directly to your email on the fast track. There's a lot of talk about bourbon and scotch, Noah.
Yeah, I know.
I feel like things might be heating up for a battle.
I have heard rumors of that.
Yeah, yeah.
Like what kind of battle?
Just a battle with sharp objects.
Mm.
Yeah. We'll probably go out to a field and try and pierce each other with swords. after a bottle and a half of our chosen beverage.
Indeed.
Yeah, stay tuned for that. That might be something that could be happening here.
Okay.
Soon. Well, I want to share with you all what I'm listening to this week, because this week what I'm listening to came courtesy of an Acoustic Tuesday viewer. George Van Wynn submitted an artist for us to check out. And in fact, if you want to do that, it's really easy. Just go to acousticlife.tv, hit submit in that upper menu, and you'll be able to submit gear recommendations, you'll be able to submit artist recommendations, and of course, submit your guitar arsenal. More on that at the end of the show. But George Van Wynn submitted an artist, and I quote George on this. He says, this is the most dedicated guitar player I've ever seen. He's faultless. And of course, next to that was the name of the artist. And the name of the artist that I want to share with you all today is Martin Simpson. Martin Simpson is an astoundingly talented guitarist. He is also an astoundingly talented banjo player. He is also an astoundingly talented slide player. let's just put it this way. Bottom line, Martin Simpson is astoundingly talented. George was dead on when he said he's just the most dedicated guitar player. I was just looking up the list of albums that Martin has to his credit, and I don't even... It took up my whole computer screen, even though it's a small computer screen. It took up a whole computer screen. And that was his solo albums. Then it went on to list off albums that he was actually on as a session player. And I was like, and that was a whole nother computer screen's worth. So this man is clearly dedicated to the acoustic guitar. And the reason I'm familiar with Martin Simpson was because actually when I was working in Chicago at the Old Town School, we had a used Martin Simpson model bourgeois guitar come in. And that I was like, oh, this guy has an artist model. I should check him out. And I was blown away. But he had fallen off my radar a little bit. And so thank you, George, for bringing him up. Martin is such a pleasure to listen to. In fact, we've got a great little selection here off of his newest album, Trails and Tribulations. The song you're going to listen to is called Blues Run the Game. And I think you'll see what I'm talking about. About Martin is that a couple of things. You'll notice that he's playing a gorgeous guitar in that video, and that is a Paul Reed Smith custom that he's playing. I believe it's a Paul Reed Smith Angelus is the base model, but he's obviously done up some really beautiful inlay on that as well. Now, also, Martin plays banjo, as I mentioned, and back in episode number 19, I featured Romero banjos. They're made out of horsefly, British Columbia, and guess who plays a Romero banjo? Noah, do you think you have a guess?
You know, Tony, I am going to guess Martin Simpson.
Yes, you're absolutely correct. And I don't know if you saw that capo he was using. Noah, did you see that capo he was using in the video?
I saw the capo.
Okay, well, if the viewers out there, if you saw the capo he was using in that video, that capo was featured on episode number 41. It's the D'Addario NS Light capo. And I thought, wow, all the Guitar Geek stars are aligning for this one. This came from a viewer recommendation. We started listening to the album here at the studio. I'm seeing all these other cool acoustic things line up. It's pretty outstanding. But as you can see, Martin is just an extremely talented player, as I mentioned. Now, he's got a bunch of albums, as I mentioned before, but here's a couple that I really enjoy that I want to share with you. I'm going to start with his newest albums and then go kind of reach further back in the years. So his newest album is Trails and Tribulations. Next up, we've got Vagrant Stanzas. And then right prior to that was Purpose and Grace. And then this next album, Prodigal Son, this is the one that got me hooked on Martin Simpson. This is the one I ordered in just pure blind faith because I saw that he had an artist model guitar and I thought, oh, this is cool. I'm going to check it out. That album is really outstanding. And then one of his very earlier albums, which is kind of really composed mostly of traditional tunes, is a Closer Walk with Thee. And you'll see by the album cover that, we're going back in time, that's for sure. The hairstyles are a little different. So, please check out Martin Simpson. You'll be so happy that you did. His tone is fantastic. His arrangement skills are really, truly top-notch, almost unparalleled. I think he has a knack for really digging into the heart of the tune and making it simple and beautiful, which is actually not very easy at all. So I want to thank George Van Wyn for recommending Martin to us to listen to. That sure was a treat, for sure. All right. At this point, I want you to share Acoustic Tuesday. flat out, flat and simple, just plain and simple, I want you to share this show with your guitar geek friends. The whole point of Acoustic Tuesday is to get guitar geeks to unite, to celebrate our small wins, to celebrate our guitar journeys, to help an amazing cause, Guitars for Vets. Again, I'll just say that every single thing that you purchase off of AcousticLife.tv, a portion, those proceeds will go to Guitars for Vets. And that is an amazing, amazing cause, and we can all certainly get behind that. So please share this show. Even it could be as simple as sending a link to AcousticLife.tv to your guitar geek friends, or it could be sharing a show that you thought was amazing with them as well, and encouraging them to subscribe to the YouTube channel. So let's unite as many guitar geeks as possible. And one of the things that we love doing on Acoustic Tuesday is celebrating small wins. And Noah, he has some for us.
Yes,
from our
own
Acoustic Tuesday viewers.
I do.
I think you should. I think it's time.
Okay, I don't know. Okay, let's do it. All right. I'm just looking at you right now.
I know. And I was looking to see where we were at, because there's so much. There's a lot to discuss today.
Is there?
There is.
Okay.
You all seem right. Thrilled. Okay.
All right. Some small wins coming your way. So first one comes from Tim K. Greetings from Kitchener, Ontario, Canada. Small win, I've had a chance to do more guitar playing than normal last week and this week since I'm on vacation.
All right.
I got to finish off Fretboard Wizard on Tony's Acoustic Challenge and dive into some other daily lessons on tack that I don't normally get a chance to do.
Sweet. And we saw Tim's guitarsonal. I think it was last week. It was either last week or the week before.
Ah.
So he's full-blown. He's a blooming guitar geek flower at this point.
I didn't even think of that. I didn't. Okay.
It's okay.
Yes. Next one comes from Denise. Hi guys, love the show. Wanted to share a small win, which is a really big win. Recently spent several happy hours at Music Emporium in Lexington, Massachusetts, trying out guitars. I sampled guitars from Claxton, Froggy Bottom, Santa Cruz, Huss and Dalton, Collings, and Loudon. All amazing. The guitar that won my heart was the Bourgeois 00 Age Tone Great.
Oh.
Adirondack.
Adirondack
Mahogany. It's on its way as I write this. Never thought I'd own a Bourgeois. Thanks to Andy at Music Emporium for his help and expertise. A great store.
Indeed. Awesome. And congratulations. New guitar day. Just one more time, Noah. What was the top wood on that guitar?
Yeah. That is the Adirondack.
Nice. We're getting
slash mahogany. I'm getting there.
We're getting there.
It's getting better.
Every time Noah sees Adirondack, his heart's just...
Okay. Last one comes from Ed G. Small win. Just bought an Eastman E1P LTD parlor guitar.
Nice.
Sweet. Thanks, awesome. Tony and Noah, for the recommendation.
Another new guitar day.
That's right.
Oh, right. Because we were emailing with him.
Yes.
That's right. That's awesome. Great pickup. Oh, that you're going to enjoy the hell out of that. That's awesome.
That's small wins for today, Tony.
Well, thank you, man. Those are good small wins. And now usually we like to reserve some time for you know you're a guitar geek wins, but I've been noted that there's an issue.
Yeah.
You brought this to my attention.
Well, you know how many we have today, Tony?
How many?
One.
Oh, man.
We've got one you know you're a guitar geek win. Now, it's a pretty good one, but still.
Well, I'd like to just take this opportunity to say to the acoustic viewers out there, Acoustic Tuesday viewers out there, please, if you want to finish the sentence, you know you're a guitar geek when, please do so in the comments below. Put hashtag, you know you're a guitar geek when, and please write that in the comments, because I'll tell you what, these are some of the funniest things I've ever read. There's been some fantastic ones. There was one about me and Frosted Flakes and Tony the Tiger.
Mm-hmm,
it was just, it kind of hit me in the right spot.
Mm-hmm.
And we need more, you know, you're a guitar geek Gwen. So please, if you have one, put it in the comments below. Now, Noah, since we only have one today, I'm just going to I'm gonna let you dramatically read it as best you can.
Thank you, Tony.
Yeah.
So this week's only, you know, you're a guitar geek Gwen comes from Brian D. And he says, you know, you're a guitar geek Gwen, you can't open the latches of your guitar case without humming the intro to all of Tony's tack videos with latches opening.
That's pretty. I saw another comment about the latches on the site. on Tony's Acoustic Challenge just yesterday or today, just how they magically open.
Oh.
And there's no hand there.
That's, gotcha.
It's wizardry at its best. Well, Noah, you know, being a guitar geek is an important job. You're aware of this, correct?
Oh, yeah. I'm aware.
And do you know one of the, dare I say it, rites of passage of a guitar geek? Do you know what the rite of passage is?
For a guitar geek?
Yeah.
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
Oh, well, let me tell you. It's okay. Sharing your guitar arsenal on Acoustic Tuesday.
Okay, I gotcha.
It's one of the pinnacle rites of passage for
guitar geek. I see where you were going. I see.
You see what I did? Yep. I was trying to set you up for a home run, but you struck out. I'm sorry. I've got two guitar arsenals today.
Yeah.
And these are fantastic because one comes from over the pond and one is from right here, actually a state that neighbors Montana. So first up, we've got Lars, and he is sharing his guitar arsenal. Lars C. is from Denmark. Now, I had the pleasure of actually meeting Lars here in Bozeman because we literally just wrapped up the Acoustic Life Festival, and I had a chance to hang out with Lars and talk guitars, and it was super, super fun. We shared it. Well, I didn't share. We didn't share a single beer. I had a beer. He had a beer. We talked guitars. It was a great moment. And of course, we'll be reporting on the Acoustic Life Festival here in a couple episodes. We've got some real special treats, so you're going to want to stay tuned for that. But Lars C., onto his guitar arsenal. This is what he says. He says, "Hello, fellow guitar geeks. I finally got around to get most of my guitars together in one room. And of course, Millie is included, the family dog. In front, I am sitting with a Martin Dreadnought Jr., an unexpected win from an early bird draw at the Acoustic Life Festival. I did not even know there was such a draw and was quite surprised when Tony wrote me." So again, congratulations, Lars, on that Martin Dreadnought Jr. Now, in terms of guitars, let's get down to business. The front row includes, this is left to right, a Martin D28, a Cordoba ukulele, a Taylor 214 CEN, a 2005 Taylor 815 CE, and a 2011 Gibson Standard Songwriter. Now, in the back row, we've got a Taylor Big Baby, a 1999 Ovation Standard Elite, a 2002 Gibson ES333 semi-acoustic, a 2010 Fender Telecaster, a Hofner bass, a Fender guitar banjo, a 1988 Ovation Custom Balladeer 12-string, and a 1979 Ovation Standard Balladeer. That is one hell of a guitar arsenal, Lars. So thank you for sharing that with us. Now, next up, we have Gus J. from Rapid City, South Dakota. And he, now this is good guitar geekiness right here. Gus just brought this to a brand new level because not only did he name the guitars that are included in his guitar arsenal, he gave this the specifics of the guitar. So we've got the actual guitar, what it is, and then what he's named it. So from left to right, we've got a Fender 50th Anniversary Strat named Axel, a Taylor 814 CE, approximately 2001, that one's named Liz. Next up, a Martin 00028 EC, that one's named Erica, Eric Clapton model, Erica, I like that. Next up, the ukulele, now that we don't have a name for that one, but I'm gonna say Tiny Guy. I'm just gonna throw that in there. And then next up, a Martin HD35, one of my personal favorite models. He says he's sorry for partly blocking that one, but that one's named Little Martha. He is holding a Washburn Koa parlor guitar. We've got a Gibson Custom Shop Hummingbird next, and that one is named Sugar Magnolia. Nice little Grateful Dead reference there. And then up a Gibson J45 Vine named Susie. Following that, a Gibson Les Paul Studio named Polly, which I thought was also pretty witty. I really dig that. And then, last but certainly not least, and really, really cool, a 1973 Washburn W400 nicknamed TOL. Well, what does that stand for, Noah?
I remember now. It stands for the old lady.
That is correct. So I want to thank Gus for really geeking out with us, sharing his guitars and their names. And of course, if you want a guitar arsenal picture featured, your guitar arsenal picture featured on an Acoustic Tuesday episode, it's actually really easy. Three steps. First of all, you got to get yourself a guitar arsenal shirt. There's a link right beneath this YouTube video. Go ahead and order your size and your color. It'll show up right to your door. Next up, take a picture with you wearing that shirt in front of all of your guitars. Include dogs, include members of your family, whomever's involved in your guitar journey, please include them. And then, of course, once you have that picture taken, please submit it at acousticlife.tv. In the upper menu, you'll see a link that says submit, and there you can submit your guitar arsenal picture and any details you wish to share about it. So thank you again, Lars and Gus, for sharing your guitar arsenals with us. I cannot wait to see your guitar arsenal. In fact, I just looked today. I've only got one left in there. There's only one guitar arsenal I haven't shared.
So we only had one. You know you're a guitar geek when you only have one guitar arsenal left.
Mm-hmm. It's time. We're trying. What Noah and I are trying to do right now is stoke the fire. We have to light up. We have to spark the inner guitar geek fire.
Yeah. Oh, and we might add, for sharing a guitar arsenal, it doesn't matter how many guitars you have.
That's correct. You could have two and be like, this is it. I found my dream guitars. Perfect. Please share that with us. That's awesome. You could have a bazillion, and that's fine as well. But just please, absolutely share your guitar arsenal with us. We love seeing that. It's just a treat to share our collections with everybody because, well, there's some really cool stuff out there. There's some really wild kind of rare guitars that some of our very own Acoustic Tuesday viewers have, which is just fun to see. It's just fun to see.
So did you say how to do that?
I did say how to do that.
Okay, how to get your guitar arsenal
featured. Three easy steps.
Oh, yeah.
Get the shirt, take the picture, submit it at acousticlife.tv.
It's so simple.
It's so simple. It's just so simple. It's so simple. All right. Well, I've got one more item for us today, and this one, I will say this. Of all the Luthiers out in the world, this is the one that I first latched onto as like, whoa, that guy makes really good guitars. And then obviously we're in a golden age right now. There's so many good makers out there, but still to this day, this manufacturer makes instruments that leave me pretty much speechless, both in aesthetic beauty and in tonal beauty as well. And in the knowledge that he has and shares with everybody. And I am talking, of course, about Dana Bourgeois of Bourgeois Guitars up in Lewiston, Maine. Dana is a wealth of knowledge. He writes for industry magazines. He is pretty much the formidable expert on voicing tops. And he really just has such care when building instruments. From picking out the materials to how the materials are treated to the end product. I mean, he's involved all steps of the way and just is just really truly a fantastic builder. One of the builders that I've looked up to for a very, very long time. I've had a chance to try some of his guitars and have always been just blown away. And I found this really cool video that shows him working in the shop and kind of explaining his philosophy. And there's a great quote in it about the materials that you gather and the way that you treat them and how both of those things are very, very important. But rather than me tell you what Dana said, I'll have Dana tell you what Dana said. So let's hear from Dana Bourgeois.
First and foremost, it's a tool for making music. I got my first guitar after I saw the Beatles on the Ed Sullivan Show, 64. And I ran into a book by Irving Sloan called Classic Guitar Construction. I thought, well, that's really cool. Design are the two important things. It all has to be properly executed. I mean, you can have a good design and pick fabulous wood and ruin the wood, you know, if it isn't well executed. There's actually very little room for error in any part of the building of the guitar. If everything's going to be right. We've got like 10 guys in the shop. You know, I've trained them all. It's a different kind of operation. This is more of an artisanal process. I'm more of a steady guy than an emotionally passionate kind of guy. I come in every day because I expect to make a little bit better one if I keep at it, you know. It's all based on that first guitar that I made in my dorm room, almost. It's a body, it's a neck, it's frets, six strings, and finish, you know. So, in that sense, they're all the same. But in reality, no two are going to be exactly alike.
One of the things that hit me was that Dana is so passionate about guitars themselves, but the whole process. I mean, it's very evident just in the way that he speaks about guitars. It's a very high reverence. So I just love the instruments that he builds. I love the way that he, well, quite honestly, I just love the way that he talks about them and knows about them in a very intimate way. Now, Noah did make a really great statement that, you know, we were watching that video as you guys were, and he looked at me very quietly and he kind of did this motion, like a beard motion. And I was like, yeah, you know what? You're right. Dana Bourgeois is a bearded guy. So clearly he's a good guy.
Oh, yeah.
He's a bearded bourgeois guitar geek.
Yeah, exactly.
I love it. Yep. I love it. Well, I want you to hear an instrument as well. One specific instrument. One of the things that I think Dana is so good at is finding the right materials, treating them the right way to create just a masterpiece, really. And one of the ones that I found was actually reviewed by Acoustic Tuesday family member Matt Chalka out at Eddie's Guitars in St. Louis. He recently featured a guitar. It was a Luthier's Choice guitar. So it was basically Dana had his pick of the litter of all the materials and everything that you could do. And he created the Big Red Small Jumbo. This guitar is stunning. And Matt does a full down breakdown, he does a full breakdown of all the specifications. He kind of goes through it in great detail, and I'm going to have that full-blown review for you at acousticlife.tv in the Bourgeois Guitars section. But he had a very special guest player play this particular guitar on his review show. So I want to actually just hand it over to Matt, and he'll go ahead and introduce the player.
We have got the great pleasure of having Courtney Hartman sit down with this guitar for just a little while and do some picking on it. I think you'll enjoy it.
Absolutely stunning guitar. I mean, plain and simple, the mother pearl fretboard, the look, that red sunburst, it's just gorgeous. So again, if you want to know more about that guitar specifically, please go to acousticlife.tv and check out the Bourgeois write-up. You'll see that full review where you can hear Matt really gushing about all the details and just what a cool guitar it is. And just in closing about bourgeois guitars, like I said, I've had a chance to try a couple different models. When I was in Chicago, we were a stocking dealer at the time, and I had a chance to try a Banjo Killer, which I ordered on name alone. I had a chance to try out a soloist, and also later I tried out, actually I tried out Matt's personal guitar, Matt from Eddie's Guitars, redwood topped Cocobolo, beautiful guitar, just in sound and in looks as well, and then also a large sound hole OM. And that very guitar, the large sound hole OM, was one of those ones where you play it and you're nearly in disbelief of what you're hearing, because it's so clear, it's so present, it's so responsiveness. So if you guys are out there and you have not tried or even heard of a bourgeois guitar yet, I would encourage you to go to one of your local dealers if they stock bourgeois and check them out. Three that I'm actually gonna note here, one was just brought up in the comments, Music Emporium. Clearly they have a bourgeois because an Acoustic Tuesday viewer just got one from them, so that's awesome. And then back in episode 40, I talked about Heartbreaker Guitars in Las Vegas as well. I know that they are a stocking dealer and they stock some really cool stuff. And of course, Matt at Eddie's Guitars in St. Louis. Matt, just in talking with him when he was here for the Acoustic Life Festival, was a wealth of bourgeois knowledge and really got a chance to pick his brain. And it sounds like they have a ton of bourgeois instruments in stock. So if you're looking to try out different models or different spec combinations, any of those three would be a good bet, a good starting point if you don't have a local dealer. So yeah, just hats off to Dana and his crew for making some of just really the most magnificent guitars out there right now. All right, that pretty much wraps up episode 46. Noah, are you ready to tuck in episode 46?
Oh yeah.
Put it to bed, read it a nice story, maybe to sing it a song or something?
Couldn't have said it better myself.
All right, well, we do have one more item of business we need to wrap up, Guitar Geek Trivia. So let's quickly revisit the question, and then I'll give you your answer. Your Guitar Geek Trivia question for today was, after Mississippi John Hurt was rediscovered and started playing again, he didn't own a guitar. In 1964, the Newport Foundation gave John Hurt funding to purchase a guitar he could call his own. He ended up buying a Guild F30. Who now owns Mississippi John Hurt's Guild F30? Was it A, John Oates, B, Boy George, C, Michael Stipe, or D, Slash? Well, if you answered A, John Oates of Daryl Hall and John Oates fame, you know, the song Maneater, you're absolutely correct. During the period of 1963 to 1966, Mississippi John Hurt played frequently in the Philadelphia area. While there, a guitarist by the name of Jerry Ricks helped John Hurt travel. After Mississippi John Hurt's death, Jerry Ricks acquired that Guild F30, and then, while working for the Denver Folklore Center, sold it to a man by the name of David Ferretta. David Ferretta unexpectedly passed away in 1994, and Harry Tuft of the Denver Folklore Center then took ownership of the Guild F30. In the year 2017, just last year, Harry Tuft received a call from John Oates asking about the guitar. John Oates had taken lessons from Jerry Ricks way back in the day and knew the F30 very well. John Oates purchased the guitar, still owns it, and it can be heard on his newest album entitled Arkansas, which actually started out as a tribute to Mississippi John Hurt. Now that is cool, to be able to follow that guitar through that many hands, and then it comes back to somebody that knew that Jerry Ricks, it's crazy to me.
Yeah.
I love our Guitar Geek world. It's too cool. It's too cool. So on that note, I want to thank you for tuning in to episode 46 of Acoustic Tuesday, but we should take a sneak peek into next week to see what's coming up. So next week on Acoustic Tuesday, we're going to learn about the heritage of a capo, we're going to take a U-turn, and we're going to stop and smell the roses. Noah and I are going to skip down the path, stop, and smell a bouquet of roses. You'll know what I'm talking about next week, of course, on Acoustic Tuesday. And if you're wondering when to catch Acoustic Tuesday, well, it airs every Tuesday at 10 a.m. Mountain Time on YouTube. And for your fix in between Tuesdays, please go to acousticlife.tv and do a deep dive on many of the Guitar Geek items and also the surprises that are there waiting for you. And not to mention this, any purchase that you make through acousticlife.tv, those proceeds go to Guitars for Vets, which is a stellar cause that unites Guitar Geeks, and here we are uniting Guitar Geeks on Acoustic Tuesday, and Guitars for Vets is uniting Guitar Geeks in a majorly powerful way. So cheers to all of you Guitar Geeks, and of course I will see you next Tuesday on Acoustic Tuesday. Until then, keep strumming, keep smiling, and cheers to you.
Catch a boat to England, baby, maybe to Spain, wherever I have gone, wherever I've been.
wherever I have gone, the blues.